How's it going, everybody? Just quick show of hands. Anybody heard of Armis? Know what we do? Okay, we've got one. Perfect. So for the rest of you guys, looking forward to kind of educating on what we do, talking a little bit about success story that we've had with Amazon in the marketplace today. So this is a journey that we are relatively new to, starting out kind of the end of last year, beginning of this year, really leaning into our partnership with AWS. And so far, it's been great. We are an entirely cloud-based solution, so very natural for us to go to market this way. I'm going to talk a little bit about who Armis is and what we do first before I get into the specific case study at a manufacturing client of ours that leveraged the marketplace to procure Armis. Just to talk a little bit about who we are and the problem we're trying to sell. There's a lot of companies here that are talking about the cloud and what's going on in the cloud. For Armis, we talk about devices and assets that exist in the modern enterprise. And how do we extend that same power of the cloud into the physical world? So when we look at a modern enterprise and the role of a CISO, CIO is, and their organizations is managing this, right? This is the IT side of the house, laptops, desktops, servers, cloud assets, the IoT assets, the printers, the security cameras. Within specialized industries, you have manufacturing equipment, SCADA, ICS, PLCs, on the healthcare side, MRI machines, connected medical devices, the list goes on, and the attack surface has increased dramatically over the last 5 to 10 years, and boundaries have all disappeared, particularly over the last 3 years with work from home due to COVID and various other things. So what does Armis seek to do? Very simply, answer what we think of as the holy grail of both IT and security over the last 20 years is, what the heck is on my network? What is it doing? And what can I do about it? So Armis does this in an entirely agentless and passive manner, sees and discovers all of the assets on your environment, and then allows you to leverage the investments you've made in other products and platforms to protect your environment. When I talk about discovering an asset, this is not just simply what is the IP address, what is the MAC address. This is contextualized awareness of what the asset actually is. Starting from the very basics, what is the make, what is the model, what is the applications that are running on this device, what are the firmware versions that are running on this device, and then we continue to go up from there from data enrichment. So let's take a tablet. A tablet is always not just a tablet, right? It depends on the particular usage of it. On the manufacturing floor, a tablet could be used as a workstation. In a conference room, that same tablet can be used in an entirely different business context. Armis places that in your hands so that you can then make security decisions based on how these devices are actually being used within your particular environment. We're mapping out the connections. Think of us, and I'm going to say a dirty word at the AWS conference, think of us as the Google Maps of your IT organization, right? Being able to understand the various relationships of those devices to each other. From there, we put additional information that you don't know about those particular devices in. This can be anything from as easy as vulnerability data for those particular devices. It could be risks associated with them, threats that we're seeing in the wild. It could be FDA recall information. Information from the government such as Section 889 based on particular devices that cannot be in an environment that serves the public sector. All of that additional data poured in so that you can have contextualized awareness of all of the devices in your environment in order to do the last thing. Data is great. Data gets you nowhere unless you can take action through automated policies and enforcement based on the investments you've made already today. So just to summarize very quickly, and I can get into the use case here, but very simply, what do I have? What is it doing and why should I care? And then what can I do about it? And then lastly, we have a number of logos here on the bottom. This isn't to simply wow you with all these great clients that we have, but it's to demonstrate one very important fact. Armis has used AWS and the power of the cloud to build a cloud-native solution that scales to the largest organizations on the planet and does it in days and weeks rather than measured deployments in months and years. You can build the best solution in the world, but if it only works in the most prettiest of manufacturing facilities or the prettiest hospital or the one site that we chose to do digital transformation at first, it doesn't matter. Armis built a solution that scales easily by taking a cloud-native, agentless, and passive approach. There's various use cases here. I'm not going to go into all of them. From the very beginning of doing something like fixing the CMDB and finally answering the question, is ServiceNow or your various CMDBs actually giving you correct information? But I want to focus in on very quickly vulnerability management and show you how actually understanding the context of the devices changes a business process that you're doing today. Currently, vulnerability management looks something like this. You have Rapid7, Qualys, some of these very good tools that are actively scanning your various devices, maybe once a week or at a particular time during the week or the month. They're ingesting the data for all the assets that can be scanned. Now, they're leaving out all of the OT assets or other assets that you should not scan because you're going to tip over. And we'll get to that in a second. Once it produces all that, it's dumping it into an Excel where you have IP addresses and CVs, and you're going to give that to the IT team and say, good luck, go fix as much as you can. There's a Fortune 50 company that I know of that is now an Armis client and does this differently, but they used to go down to the top 20 most severe CVEs, draw a line in their Excel spreadsheet and say, the rest of it, we're never going to get to and we're not going to care about. Regardless of what the actual device is that were associated with those, they were just going to fix the top 20. How does this look like with Armis? Armis takes all of that data from Rapid7, Qualys, Tenable, whoever it is, ingests it into our system. We also complete the picture. So if you look at those OT assets, those medical assets, because as I said earlier, we know the make, model, applications that are running, firmware, we can deduce what are the vulnerabilities that are applicable to those assets and give you a full picture of all the vulnerabilities that you have. Well, great, congratulations, I've now given you even more vulnerabilities to go fix. How do we fix that, and how do we go from this number that here it's 12,000, any large organization, it could be 500,000, could be over a million. We take that vulnerability data and attach it to your actual assets. And so then you can look at your assets and say, what do I actually care about? And do a stack ranking based on whatever criteria you particularly have, right? So do we want to look at your money-producing or revenue-producing assets on the manufacturing floor or healthcare assets? Is it your accounting system, right? Is it your crown jewels within the cloud? What are the assets you actually care about? And then when you go to your vulnerability team, and in the conjunction with IT, you actually know you're moving the ball, and you can tell your management, tell even the board, look, we address what's most critical to the business by attacking the vulnerabilities that are most impacting our organization. So that's just one example of how actually having context of the particular assets applies to your business and can move the ball forward. What I want to talk about now is a case study. This is for a manufacturing client of Armis that we transacted via the marketplace, and this client had these exact same problems that we've talked about so far. They did not understand what were all of the IT assets, what were all of the operational technology assets on the manufacturing floor within their environment, and they were stuck with all of the downstream implications of that from a security and IT standpoint. So what was Armis able to do? We were very quickly able to deploy to all of their manufacturing sites and their corporate environment, discover all of the assets with contextualized awareness of what those assets are, and then overlay on top of that vulnerability management so they could stack rank and go back to their teams, go back to their management, go back to their board, and tell them that our team is using our resources in the most effective way possible for this business. The really interesting thing from our perspective is this deal grew seven times, or this scope of the deployment grew seven times once we were able to leverage Amazon Marketplace based on the commitment that that client had made to Amazon. And really, it was a match made in heaven for us between AWS and this particular client, and we're looking forward to leveraging this similar approach with many other clients going forward. With that, that's really all I wanted to share here today, but I would love if anybody has any questions to ask now, or we can talk afterwards as well.